Hey guys, welcome to DevOps School. In this video tutorial, we are going to learn about Docker. It helps us to create, deploy, and run applications by using containers. After going through this tutorial, I promise you that the concept and understanding of the Docker will be absolutely clear to you. But before that, let me ask you a few things. Are you dreaming of a career with higher pay and more responsibilities? Or are you ready to take your skills to the next level this year? Then start investing in DevOps School certification level courses, which will help you to emerge skills for a wide range of entry-level roles and as well as higher potential future positions. But with thousands of courses online and in classroom worldwide, finding the right one for your career goals can be difficult. You can consider our courses like Agile Developer, Agile QA, DevOps Certified Professionals, Site Reliability Engineering, DevSecOps, and Masters in DevOps Engineering, where you will have access to well-structured, easy-to-follow course content that has been developed and will be delivered by industry professionals. You can join on our training programs globally through online platforms, and if you are looking for classroom workshops, then we have regular sessions available in Bangalore, Hyderabad, Chennai, Delhi NCR, Mumbai, and in Pune. Simply compare our many courses, find the one that suits your style and schedule best, and start today.
So yeah, so Docker, these are the commands which I run just to make you comfortable. These are the like Docker V, Docker help run info version images. So I was talking about the Docker images is a command which will give you a list of images what you have in the local registry. Okay, so see right now, registry has a repository and I have none right now. So repository, tag, image ID, created, site. So all these are local registry. Okay, so this is the images. I have none actually. So how can I download the images? So guys, we have to take a call. What you want to run inside a container. The question is what applications you want to run in container. So now this is a voting for all of you. So in the chat window, can you please mention one of the software which you want to run in a container? One of the software. Okay. So can you please quickly say in the chat window, which are the applications you want to run? It can be anything. When I say anything, you must be working in some project. And it can be anything, whatever you want to run. And I said application. Application means anything. Yeah, Git Bash, Apache, App Server like a Tomcat or something like that probably. Java, Jenkins, wonderful. Yeah, so any other applications? Continue, keep writing each one of you. Eclipse is the editor, so probably Nginx. Okay, it's a good application, right? Okay, what else? Jenkins, yeah. What else? HTTPD. JBoss. Visual Studio Code. Okay, yeah. Anyone who is trying to run the flavor of Linux also, like Fedora, Debian, SUSE, Ubuntu, RHEL, CentOS, you know, all these things also can think about it. HP 45, that's so good. Yeah, database like MySQL, Oracle, Postgres, you know, MS SQL, all these things. Yeah, you can run it. Yeah, so basically, guys, yes, you can run any application inside a container. And let me tell you here, for running the container, you need an image. And for the time being, where we are going to download the image. So we will go and get the images at hub.docker.com. Okay, hub.docker.com. Okay, so here, this is the place. So now let's say one of the image which I'm using right now is Jenkins. Okay, remember, if those who don't know about the Jenkins is a Java based application. That means to run Jenkins, you have to have a Java. Okay, now Jenkins has a two things, web, which runs on 8080, and one is agent or node where the build server is there, and the port number is 50,000. Okay, now Jenkins, see here, it's like this. Jenkins, to run, you need operating system. Operating system has what? Yeah, so understand that operating system and JDK, and then on top of Jenkins. This is the combination. But right now, remember, in the container, you don't have operating system. When I divide, what is operating system? Operating systems divided into the multiple file system, which is called boot file system plus root file system plus application file system. Remember, in shortcut, I am saying, please understand that. I have explained it to you already. So here, remember, I don't need operating system. I need an image. So image, what is that? Image is like root file system and application file system. Understand that. So this is the image. An image has root file system. Let's say that is Ubuntu. Think about it, or it can be Debian, any flavor of Linux. Or application file system, that means JDK plus Jenkins. So here in this image, whenever we say Jenkins, this image, you have this one. Debian's, I know that. One flavor of Linux, like a CentOS, which we are using right now. Okay. And JDK and Jenkins. You can have only these two images also. You can have a Debian images also. You can have all these three, which we have right now. So from where to get it? Go ahead and search for it. So here I'm searching Jenkins. Like that, whatever the images you have mentioned in the chat box, you can search during the demo time. You can explore. So guys, here you have a Jenkins. See that so many search results have come up. Now you can also filter by certified, verified, official images and categories. And you can see the number of download. You can see the number of stars. You can see everything. You can see the tag with the official images, everything. Just click on it. And now if you want to download this image, copy this here, run this in the place where your Docker client. And it's downloading. It will take few seconds, not more than that. Okay, now you have a Docker images. So here, clear the screen. Here Jenkins tagged with the latest image ID 2 years ago. This is the size of image. So this is the image I downloaded using pull command and I got it. Now after that image, once we got it here, then I'm going to follow this life cycle. So let me do that in front of you. So here create a container. Start the existing created container or stop container or kill container. Stop running container will stop it, start it, restart it, pause, unpause, kill and remove. As name itself has some explanation. So let me start doing this. So Docker create Jenkins and Docker ps. Docker ps command, let me reiterate, Docker ps command will tell you the running container. Docker ps hyphen a command will tell you all container which is running or created or exited. Again, I am repeating. Docker ps command will tell you running container, whereas Docker ps hyphen a command will tell you created, exited and running container. In short, all containers. Okay. So here, when I say ps, there's no container which is running because I created a container. Now, when I say ps hyphen a, now it got created. This container ID from image inside the container, this is running and created 9 seconds ago. Now, I am going to start this container. So Docker start. Container ID, Docker PS, now it's running. You see here, this is the container ID from Jenkins image. This is the things and up for the, see up 2 seconds and 8080 port, which is a web port, node port, name of the container, which is randomly generated. Okay. So this is the container's detail. Now guys, let me tell you here, I said one more statement. From the one image, you can create as many containers you wanted. See here. So can I create one container more? So let me create one container more. So Docker create. And from which image? From Jenkins image, which you have downloaded. Guys, I created one more container. You see here. I got one more container. Like that, you can create one more container. See here. So as many containers you can create it, whereas I have created two containers, one is running. Can I start the another container also? And see here. Now it started. So now Docker ps hyphen a all together. I have a two container running, one container in a created state. Now, so this is the create start. Can I stop this container? So yes, I am going to stop this container. So Docker stop container ID stopped it. Now you see here, see, exited. That means the container which you stopped it will get exited. Exited means what? Understand that. Exited means a container has run at least once. Again, I'm repeating. Exit means container has run at least once. This container has not run so far because I have never started. But it is exited. Exited means it has run and then exit. So understand that way. There's a difference between exit and created. Up means it's running. So now, can I stop this other container also, which is up? Container ID, stop. You can use the name and container ID both to work with the container. I stopped it. What next? Can I start it? So this time I'm going to start it, but both the containers together, or all three containers together, separated by space. One containers or all containers, up to you. Now you see here, Docker PS, and all these three containers up, and it's running. So Docker, this one is running and good to go ahead. So now we got the three containers, all three containers got PS and started. Now you are going to restart this. So Docker, see here, just count it here, Docker PS up. So here, clear the screen, up 35 seconds, up 34 seconds. So all three containers you have up, all three containers you have up. Now restart all the containers. So Docker restart. And container ID. This one. See here, look at the status. I restarted, means stopped and started. So now it's up again. Earlier it was up from last 35 seconds. Now this one. So this is the way you can restart it. Now I'm going to pause this container. One container I'm going to pause it. So Docker PS Docker pause and container ID. I see pause. And when I see pause, you see here the container PS paused. See here. Now you need to tell me what is the difference between pause and unpause. This is the assignment for you, which you're going to tell me during the lab time. Okay, so this is the one. I'm going to unpause also. Now I got it unpause. Here it is. And then finally, I'm going to kill this container. So Docker PS Docker kill and this container and here only two is running. So if I do PS hyphen A, it'll be get killed means also get exited. But you need to tell me, you need to teach me what is the difference between stop versus kill, and then finally remove the container. So yes, you can remove only the exited containers. So right now, how many containers got exited? As of now, only one, and there's a remove kill container and done. So guys, all together, this is the workflow working of the container. Yeah, any questions so far?
Yeah,
tell me.
Yeah, when you try to create three images using the Jenkins, all are created with the same port.
All that created
for example in the host container.
Probably question is, and sir, by the way, there's lots of disturbances from your side. Probably the question is, I am creating three containers. So, all these containers is the same. I think you missed that concept again. Let me recall this. Each container here get their own network. So, can here not share network like you and me? Okay. So, each container they get their own network. So this container is also running on 80 port. This container also running on 80 port. This container also running on 80 port. Why we cannot run 80 port? Because we use a shared network. That means one user, two user, three user, four user, we, you and me, logged into one box. We will use a shared mount, shared network, shared PID. But here in the case of container, each container will use their own PID table, mount and network namespaces. Because of that, each container internally can run on 80 port or 80 and like that. So did you understand that?
Yeah, I got it. But still, like for example, user one wanted to try to access this Genki and he is creating some job, test underscore job one. So the user two also can able to see the same test now. You mean to say that since he is also accessing the same port?
Sir, you have to repeat one more time your question, please.
For example, we have user 1, 2, 2, 3. All the three users are accessing the same port, 88. And I am the user 1, and I think that this is Jenkins web query. I created a test job. And will the user 2 can access the same job?
Sir, there's a so much of disturbances coming from you. Probably what you are asking a question is, container is nothing but a user, and what you are trying to say, if this user is trying to run on 80 port the Jenkins, so second user, how it will be able to run or something like that?
Yeah, right, exactly.
Sir, I think again I'm repeating the same thing again. These containers are assigned with the user namespace, but which have their own network. You forgot that. Each user has their own network specification. When you say you are the user, you use share network. That means, let me put it in a simple way, you log in and I log into my laptop, we both of us will use the share network, whereas if Docker create the container, they will have their own network namespaces. Because of that, each container can run on the same port because of network namespace are different.
Okay.
Remember the question I said right here? Let me go back to the same discussion. Here I said, we get one namespace, one network namespace, one mount, one PID, but multiple user. It's a normal behavior. But in containers, we get one user namespace, one network, one PID, one MNT, and each container gets their own. Here, we do not get own. All the users share the same PID, same MNT, same network. Because of that, we cannot have same PID. Because of that, we cannot see two C drive, and because of that, we cannot start the port at 80 to application. Are you getting my points now?
I got it.
Yeah, guys, more questions?
If you liked our Docker session so far, please enroll our general membership for $3.99 plan to get access of all the parts.
Along with that, you can access our other tutorials such as Docker, Ansible, Jenkins, Terraform, Splunk, AWS, Azure, and various other DevOps related premium tutorials with our channel membership. If you would have any issues with our channel membership, you can drop an email to us at contact@devopschool.com, or you can also unsubscribe from channel membership anytime if you don't want to continue or did not like the video. To get our channel membership, click onto the join button, select the $3.99 plan and grow your skills immensely.
Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries. We will reply to them at the earliest.
Thanks for watching.